Institute of Security. So with the President Hayes, level of the team for the civil investigation.
I would be very careful with healing. We never talk about healing or curing, and we always talk about improving. Depends on the state of disease, which symptoms you have, and how serious the symptoms are, we can improve it. We can improve the central nerve system, muscle cells, heart cells, liver, kidney cells, all the organ cells which are needed, even nerve, even cells from the central nerve system and muscle cells can be stimulated and be activated. But I cannot tell you all of the cerebral palsy will be cured in palsy. That is impossible, and that is what I don't tell you. We can improve certain stages, certain patients with a cerebral palsy. That depends, but also on the symptoms in which state the patient is. Pressure therapy is always in patient individual treatment. I cannot say all the diabetic patients will have the same result, all the cerebral palsy will have the same result. You need to give us information and then we can tell you what we can do for you.
Okay, thank you. Good afternoon, sir. I just want to know, what is the difference between fresh cell and stem cell therapy?
Basically, we are using stem cells and organ cells from animals, which we think is right now the most developed technique. And there are scientific studies going on from major pharmaceutical industry and companies like Roche, Bayer, Pfizer. They're also doing research in how to use your own stem cells from the bone marrow, the spinal cord or umbilical cord, or even from your blood and from your fat, extract them, and how can you use your own stem cells, bring them back into your body, bring them first back to an unborn stage, a fetal stage, and probably remove any disease marker from these stem cells. But science is in this field very young, and it might take a few more years or even decades to find a way to really use your own stem cells and then implement them right into your organ, and then the bone cells will come out of the body, will be multiplied, and will be brought into your body again, will be also accepted from your body. But there is a lot of steps which need to be taken. This happens, that will be definitely in the future. And so now we see it more successful to do it with stem cell or T cells from sheep.
Okay, we have another question from Florence.
Yes, good afternoon. My question is, in terms of research, is there also, do you also consider the number of, let's say, race or ethnicity, because there's also, is it also a factor that race could also affect the effectivity of fresh cell therapy?
Not really. We treat normally patients from Europe, United States, and Western people. For the last 60 years, we started treating Asian people around 20, 25 years ago, with the first people from Singapore, Malaysia, and around 15 to 20 years, I started with China. We also treat a lot of patients from Vietnam, Philippines, Thailand, Taiwan. We don't see any difference in how good cells can be stimulated. All the organs look the same. If you take an organ from the Philippines, the heart, and then compare it with the heart from it's not that much difference. And it's even in the structure, it's a little different. The function, how you stimulate heart cells, is definitely the same. So we don't see any difference in that part.
Thank you. Also, have you partnered with any local institutions here or probably research centers that would also help develop fresh cell therapy more here in Asia or the Philippines?
We have now here a partner, which is DS Block Cell Therapy in the Philippines. which is, we've chosen this partner because they are doing great work, they're helping the patients, also they are also having the patient here to find out if they are suitable, if they can do the cell therapy there, and just to make sure that we are not always met long distance. We have a partner here who can help the patient with visa, with the application process, also can inform them and help them if they're suitable or not. But they're always in direct contact with our doctor's team in case there are any questions.
Okay, thank you very much.
Last question from Rufi. Good afternoon, doctors. Dr. Blau. With so many clinics doing the same procedure, how are you different from them? How are you different from different clinics?
And as I mentioned, we are only doing fresh cell therapies. That means we're only using the cells itself, no chemical agents, and only the pure whole cells. We're not combining it with other therapies because we believe strongly in the strategy and also the success of injecting the full cells without any other treatments and getting the best result out of that. Other clinics might use more treatments, but then the effect is they have to lower the cell dosage then, because when you inject such high dosage, what we do, plus other treatments during the treatment, that would overload, problem or stress your body. That is what we don't want. We want to that we see success. You come from cell injection, we want the pure cell injection, that is what we get from us. You know that there are other clinics who say, okay, I'm using extracts, low dose cell injection, and combine it with other treatments, but that is not our strategy. And we don't see that much success with the other strategy. We see the most success with our strategy and our business.